Hey friends, great to have an interaction with all of you. This is the first large initiative from the Yes Securities Group to end up ensuring financial literacy among investors that are there across asset classes. A lot of my colleagues would be speaking on various asset classes, including debt, equity, and commodities, etc., which will end up making sure that we work along with all of you in building a secondary source of income for each one of you. Most of you, over a period of time, would be having a successful working career or running successful businesses, small and large, across board. But it is always advisable that you build up a pool of capital by the side, which will end up ensuring that you have an alternate source of income apart from your regular source of income. This will ensure that all of you, over a period of time, will not be dependent on the main line of activity that you are into, but you have a safeguard that is there, a safety net that you have created because of investments that you make over a period of time. These investments will end up helping you in wealth creation and to create prosperity for you and your family and safeguard them from any uncertainties that are there. Needless to say, insurance remains one of the most important aspects as far as ensuring that your family and your loved ones are protected for life. Since my colleagues will be running through the other investment avenues that are there, I am going to touch upon an area which is very close to my heart, an area which is regularly disregarded by investors across board as having impact on their investments. And if you can guess it, it is something that is not related to the companies that you're investing in. It is not related to the sector that you're investing in. But it is definitely related to the nation and its progress that happens. And these are called macro factors which affect the population, the citizens of a country overall that is there. So when we study these factors, there are three broad classifications that we can end up looking at. One are geopolitical factors, the second one are environmental factors, and lastly are economic factors. Now, how do they affect your investments? Have you ever thought about it? From our perspective, when we end up looking at it, what are geopolitical factors that we talk about? These are wars, these are cross-border trades that have happened and have caused problems. These are factors which end up creating issues for the growth of the economy of a particular country. Simple examples that you can end up looking at in recent past that all of you would have heard enough about is the US-China tensions that are going on. And needless to say, that was a large period of time that the stock markets and your investments would have been affected by these interconnected economies that are there. So it was a fight between a US and China trade, but it affected even the stock market in India. It can be a factor like your Brexit that happened when Britain wanted to move away from the European nation. But it affected businesses, it affected economies across board because you're dependent on these factors at any point. You can have another example that you have taken care of in the same macro factors that you talk about is the environmental factors, the natural disasters that happens, the weather-related changes that happen, which will end up ensuring the well-being of a nation. The financial health. Let's assume that you have had a bad storm, a typhoon, a rain in a location where factories are present in large, and production comes down. Clearly, it affects the financial health of the nation because income from those factories would have stopped. Income from those areas, that sector, that area those factories are present in would have stopped. It will affect a lot many other parameters which will affect the GDP of a nation. Lastly, the one that you are most probably most adept to listening to is the economic factors. Most companies across industries tend to do well in an environment which is friendly for them to do business in. There are export-related measures, government support that is large, tax incentives that are given to end up ensuring that the economy either becomes buoyant or reaches high growth parameters, which will end up ensuring that the overall income parameters for each of those citizens because of a booming economy ends up having an impact on the overall economy. Now, conversely, the opposite can also happen. Suddenly, demand dries down. You have issues regarding production that will happen because of regulatory issues that happen. An example is the pharma industry. If your factory is under review because of a regulator coming and checking out your factory and you have been found wanting, the factory is supposed to be closed till those factors are sorted out. So you have issues regarding economic factors, and largely these are labeled under three or four that are known as. First and foremost, that all of you would be aware of, which impacts pickup of the economy in general or slowdown of the economy in general, are the interest rates that you would have heard most of the panelists talk about regularly. Please understand that when your interest rates are low, as in personal life, when you would go out to buy a house for yourself or a car for yourself, when interest rates are low, you end up buying an asset that you will use for a long term at that period of time. Similarly, for companies that are functional, when you have low interest rate regime that is continuing, a company will think about making investments and growing their businesses to end up ensuring that you have future growth for their shareholders and for the company by itself. And reverse to that is, in case interest rates are very high, the first thought that a person of an individual nature will have will be to pay back your loan so that the interest burden comes down, especially in a floating rate environment. Similarly, for a company which has a heavy burden of interest rates on its balance sheet, it will decide to slow down on fresh capex from its side and think about conserving capital, saving their bottom line, and ensuring that their shareholders end up making money even in a tough environment of growth. Interest rates are directly linked to inflation that happens. Interest rates are measures used by regulators traditionally to end up making sure that inflation is kept under control. What is inflation? In simplistic terms, what you could buy with 100 rupees in this year won't have the same buying capacity in the next year because inflation would have eaten up into those earnings at that point of time. So if you could buy, say, a kilo of apples for an X rate this time, maybe next year, because of inflation, you will be able to buy only 900 grams of apples. It's a simplistic example for you to understand how inflation allows you to buy more or reduce consumption, which will affect the regulators to take decisions on controlling interest rates at any point of time. All of this is linked to a simple terminology called the gross domestic product, which represents the total economic value of the goods and services produced by the country at any point of time. A steady growth in GDP is typically considered favorable for the economy. And too high a growth rate in GDP causes overheating, which will be followed by contraction. And while too low numbers can depict a declining phase of negative growth. In simple terminologies, all this is linked to all of the investment and liquidity which flows into the markets to support your investments at any point of time. So it is important for you as an investor to end up ensuring that you keep track, along with the micro factors that your companies that you have invested in, the portfolio that you have invested in, be it either into equity, debt, commodity, any portion. Also keep track of the macro factors that we have already described. Typically, the monetary policy that a government bases its entire growth that it plans for its economy is based on the factors that we have talked about: your inflation, your interest rate, your GDP, whether they want to push growth into the GDP, whether they want to support the GDP. Giving you an example, because that you can talk about, it can be as simple things that you would hear regularly analysts talking about, because all of this affect the way the government ends up bringing a policy to support businesses that are there in India. Traditionally, you would have heard something called national income, employment, economic growth, industrial production, things that are monitored closely by the government before it releases its monetary policy on a regular basis. Even the budget that is presented takes into factor these effects, these points that I have spoken about, such that you have a powerful economy, strong enough to end up building wealth for its citizens at any point of time. Thank you, and I hope you will give a lot more importance to macro factors which affect your investment decisions at any point of time, along with the other factors of choosing your right investment advisor, along with choosing the right investment tools and asset allocation to end up having a fruitful and safe, prosperous future for yourself and your family. Thank you.